What's up you guys, welcome to my channel, and today we are going to have a new video as per your request. Today we are going to locate the numbers square root of 2, square root of 3, and square root of 5, and square root of 10 in a graph or number line by Pythagoras theorem. We know that, let us consider a triangle with sides A, B, C. Using Pythagoras theorem, the formula for this triangle is going to be AB square is equals to AC square plus CB square. This means that in this triangle, the hypotenuse is AB, and the formula goes AB square, that is hypotenuse square, is equal to the sum of the squares of the other two sides of the triangle. It is represented in this formula. Now we are going to first take the number root 2. Now we are going to use this root 2 and we are going to represent this root 2 in a number line. So let's draw the number line first, and let's name it half. And 1, 3 by 2, 5 by 2. And origin is 0. Now 1, 3 by 2, 2, 5 by 2. And bottom side half 1, 3 by 2. This is negative numbers because it is in the down part, which is the negative of y axis. And you can give this side also, but for now let it be. Now the origin is 0, which is in the center. Now we are going to use this formula and get the value for root 2. So let's see how we'll get it. You can see first root 2. So by using the Pythagoras theorem, let's say a b square is equals to, so I'll tell you the trick, that what is the sum that will give you 2. We can get 2 by just adding 1 plus 1, which gives us the sum of 2. So which means that we have to give AC the value 1 and CB also the value 1. So by using that thing, we can also write 1 square, which is because we are having square here, plus 1 square, because we are having square again here. Now AB whole square is equals to 1 square is 1 and 1 square is 1. So 1 plus 1 is going to be 2. So as we know that by sending this square to the right hand side, it will become square root. So by that, AB is equals to square root of 2. Finally, we got the value of AB is equals to square root of 2. So to get this square root of 2 in this graph, so now we are going to do this triangle. We are going to take the center as B. So now we are going to take CB is equals to 1. So B, let's take this as C, and this length is going to be 1 unit, and the length from AC, from the A to C, means this is the C. So let's take the A point in the y axis side. So this C and A, so the A will be 1 unit in the y axis side. So 1 unit is here, so C and 1 unit are going to intersect at this point. So this point is going to be denoted as A. So now we have got the point B, we have got the point C, we have got the point A. So this A point is by giving the combination of y axis, 1 unit of y axis and 1 unit from the x axis. The point which intersects let us represent it as point A. So by the Pythagoras theorem, the point AC is also going to be having 1 unit of distance. 1 unit, you can do units in the sum of, in the terms of centimeters or meters, etc. That's your wish, but we are going to take it as a standard unit. So 1 unit, 1 unit. So now as per the Pythagoras theorem, the AB point in the number line is AB point here. So we have to join this origin, the B point and the A point, to make a hypotenuse. The hypotenuse which we are seeing here is the hypotenuse here. So in this, as we already got that AB is root 2, so this line which is going from point O to point 1 comma 1 in the graph, in the graph or the number line, is going to be root 2, as we have already got derived the value of AB as root 2. So like this, we have got already place the number root 2 in the number line or number sequence.
You can also use the geometry terms, like you can also take the distance from C to A and from this one point to A, and you can just draw, take a compass and take one unit of distance, like 1 centimeter, so 1 meter, which I have specified here. You can take that and you can just extend this. Yeah, you can take 1.4 as the radius of the compass. You can take B as the center point, and you can draw an arc in the graph. And again, from C as the center, which is 1 unit away from the B or origin, you can again take the compass, measuring 1 unit or 1 centimeters of distance.
Another point A is created. So, and you can just represent root 2 in the graph. Let's consider the next one, which is root 3.
3, just take a graph. Let the center point be O, or you can denote it as B also. And this side, half, 1, 3 by 2, 2, 5 by 2. These are the points on the x axis, and on the y axis, half,
3 by 2, and 2. Okay, now let's see what's going to be happening when we use root 3.
In root 3,
added by the sum 2 and 1, because 2 plus 1 is equal to root 3, and there are no other possibilities for root 3 to occur. So 2 plus 1 is root 3. Now we are going to take the two sides, let's say B
is equal to root 2 and CD is equal to 1, and
Pythagoras theorem. And by applying Pythagoras theorem, we can find the hypotenuse. Let us assume the hypotenuse of this triangle is going to be BD. Now BD square is equals to BC square plus CD square. Now already know that BC is equals to root 2 and CD is equals to 1, because from the previous one which we have done here, you can same apply this for this one here, which is, this is about the root 2
which we have done in the previous sum. So let's directly substitute it. BC is equals to root 2 whole square plus 1 square. Now it's going to be 2 plus 1, which is going to be 3 BD whole square. Now same, we have to send this square. This will be, if you send this square to the right hand side, which will become the square root. BD is equals to square root of 3. Now this is the same thing that we have got previously, which is square root of 2. Now we are going to find square root of 3. So we have to find the BD line in this number line. That is simple. So as per the same previous one, we have to just draw the root 2 first, so that we can proceed further to find the root 3. So same as before, you have to take B as a center, and then you have to do 1 unit to the x-axis and make a point, and 1 unit to the y-axis and make a point. Now you have to just take the compass and take the 1 unit distance from B. You just take the center as 1 unit in the x-axis and just draw an arc in the graph. I am doing just normally, you can do use it with your compass. And now from the y-axis, take 1 unit distance as the center of the compass and just draw, cut the arc which is already present with the x-axis, which we have already done. So now just join these 2 points and just join these 2 points, this one and this one. Unit of x-axis and 1 unit on the y-axis are joined. Now this line, the hypotenuse of this one, which is root 2, is going to be joined. So we just join this one. So this one is going to be the value of root 2, and let's denote this point as C. Now we are going to find root 3. We have already seen here that root 3 is a combination of
root 2 and digit 1. We have already completed the root 2 task here. So now we are going to add this one more unit to the number line. So how do we add this 1 unit to the number line? You have to just increase the y-axis to 1 unit, so that you can add this 1 unit, as you have already seen here. 3 is a combination of 2 plus 1. So same thing applies here. Already root 2 is completed in this one. Now we have to just add one more unit to the y-axis. This means we have to just increase this y-axis line one more unit. So let's improve this to one more unit, which is going to be 2 units. So, and this is going to be a point. Let us assume this point as D, which is the distance is 1 unit. Now you can see that if you can join this point B to D, then we can get a triangle with a hypotenuse of BD. So let's join these two points B and D. Now you can see it as BDC is a triangle and the hypotenuse is the longest side of the triangle. So the longest side of the triangle is going to be BD with the value root 3. If you want, you can also verify this one by using hypotenuse theorem, like root 3 whole square is equal root 2 whole square plus 1 whole square. Now root 3 whole square is equals to square root cancel 2 plus 1. Here also square root is cancelled, so 3 is equals to 3, so LHS is equals to RHS. So hence proved, the number line which you have drawn is correct.
Yeah, this is the root 2 in the number line and number root 3 in the number line. Again, I told again there are two more things, root 5 and root 10. You can apply the same thing, the same formula. You have to just know what are the digits that are used to get the sum of these numbers, and then you have to represent them in the form of a graph. I would like you to practice root 5 and root 10 after watching this video, and if you have any doubts or any, if you want any clarifications from me, you can comment in the comment box below. I will definitely see and answer your all the comments. If you want me to solve and show you the number graphs of root 5 and root 10, I will definitely solve in the next part. Be ready for the next part. If you want, I'm definitely going to do it in another video if you want me to do it. And that's all from this video today. I hope you like the video. If you found this video informative, please like, comment, share and subscribe to Teaching Knowledge, and we'll see you next time. Thank you.